Hey, I got some cool stuff to show you guys. So I've been working on UI-based microservices or micro UIs, and I've done quite a lot of research into UI composition. In my previous video, I spoke about how I want to build a UI and avoid building a monolithic UI and have all the different UI components decoupled. And it turns out that there's no right or wrong way. It's all about the trade-offs. It's all about how much code reuse do you want? How much code sharing do you want? How much duplication of code do you want and libraries that you're pulling in externally? How much will page speed be affected when you're pulling in all these external libraries and you're duplicating a lot of code? Your page gets bigger and heavier, and that'll affect the page speed. There's also, where do you render it? Do you render on the client side or on the server side? And so it's about choosing, when you're building this architecture, it's about choosing the trade-offs and making sure you're picking the right components where you can optimize for page speed, optimize in terms of isolation, and the main goal is team autonomy. So you want teams, maybe distributed remote teams, working on their components, and they need to be able to release effectively and quickly. So there's three technologies to achieving UI composition, and I'm going to talk about the first one, which is a bit of a legacy one. It's been around for years, and it's called iframes. Now, a lot of people cringe when they hear the word iframe, and that's because it's a very old technology, but it is very effective in giving you isolation of a component, because you can have all your JavaScript libraries and dependencies in there. It doesn't affect the page around it. There's a lot of companies that, when I did my research, they're still using, and these are modern companies using modern agile DevOps development, and they're still using iframes to achieve isolation. The second component I want to show you guys is web components, and this is, it's basically a suite of different technologies allowing you to create custom elements. So you can create a header element, you can create a footer element, and you can create various body elements, and each element can be sourced from a different microservice, and the teams can look after these microservices independently and deploy them independently from one another without them affecting each other. And the way this achieves this is it uses a shadow DOM, which is a set of JavaScript APIs for attaching an encapsulated shadow DOM. So this is separate from the main DOM, and here it says so they can be scripted and styled without fear of collision with other parts of the document. So this is kind of like a more modern iframe type of technology from what I can see here. The only downside to this is there's limited browser compatibility, but they do have this fallback called polyfills, which allows you to some sort of a workaround for older browsers. So this is something I want to look at. It's pretty cool. The only thing with this is that it doesn't give me from an architectural point, doesn't give me that separation just yet. So when I was digging further, I found this article published by ThoughtWorks, and this is really, really good. This is a high performance solution to microservice UI composition. And in this video, I'll link it down in the description for those of you interested. They talk exactly about this problem, about pretty much here, maximizing autonomy for your teams. They talk about having a single UI and then rendering UI components inside of that. They have built a system called Jigsaw, and they use Nginx server-side includes to pull in content. So in my previous video, I showed how I running an Nginx microservice for my frame of my site, and how I'm sourcing my header, body, and footer from the same, from different HTML files. So what I didn't realize is that there is actually a remote server-side includes. You can actually use Nginx to proxy pass to different backends. So I can have a header microservice, a footer microservice, a body or content microservice, and you can split these up to, you can go as small as you want with this. And the frame microservice, its purpose is to just call out to the backend microservices and render the page. So this video, they talk mainly about page speed, and this is the good thing because the frame microservice will reach out to the backend services, it'll get the header, the body, and the footer, and it'll render it and send it back to the client. So the client doesn't need to do all this AJAX calls, like you don't have the page coming to the browser, rendering partially, downloading more JavaScript, and then making AJAX call back to the servers and all these microservices, and then bringing more content in. So you don't have that slow performance. This is a very good for page speed optimization. Okay, so before we start to build and write code and look at the deployment, I want to show you my architecture diagram for micro UIs. So we spoke about Nginx server-side includes, and this is something I'm going to be using. So we have a customer, and customer as a browser, and makes a call to our environment, our website. Okay, when the call comes in, we're gonna have the frame microservice, and its purpose is to render the frame. That's it. It's going to give an HTML the header content, it's going to give the body and the footer content. That's it. If you look at the page, this is all the page has. And what we're going to do is we're going to use Nginx server-side includes to make a remote call. So when we want the header in the page, we have /header. And in the page here, we have /content, which goes in the body, and we have /footer. And what we're going to do is we're going to be making a call to the header microservice and make a call to the content microservice, and it's going to make a backend call to the footer microservice. The header microservice has HTML related to the header. The content obviously has the body, and the footer will have the footer information. Now, these microservices can be scaled independently. They're separate Nginx Docker containers that will run, and the frame is separate. So we have four microservices part of our architecture, and this will render our UI for now. So let's code. When it comes to okay, so I've reworked our architecture repo, and this is all on GitHub, so you can head over to my GitHub and you can see all the work that's been done here. And this is our scalable microservice architecture work in progress. You can follow along on YouTube, so please remember to like and subscribe, and remember to turn on the little bell next to the subscribe button so that you get notified when I upload. So we spoke about this already, composite UIs, we built four microservices, we have Docker and Docker Compose that we'll be using to deploy this locally. Now, this is a reference architecture repo, so you can see I created a repositories folder, and this basically symbolizes all the different Git repos that we would have in the real world. So we have our architecture repo where we put our design docs in and the bootstrapping scripts to spin this all up. And then each of the microservices is listed under each of these Git repos. So I'll take you through, for example, the content service is a has a Docker file. It's just a simple Nginx tiny microservice. It serves the content, which is just this paragraph. And there's an Nginx configuration, which is a stock standard, just serves a static file called index.html. And that's the content service. The footer service, very similar, also has a Docker file. And its index is obviously just the footer. So this microservice will serve us this footer content. And if we look at the header service, it'll give us the header, which is the nav bar, everything on the top of the header. That's its responsibility. And to put this all together with Nginx SSI, we have the frame microservice. And it's responsible for giving us the page. The page, which is just the frame, you can see we have a includes virtual for the header, the content, and the footer. So this is the magic that Nginx will call the backend APIs. And the way it does this is in our Nginx configuration, we've turned SSI on. And for each of these locations, we've turned SSI on. And it has an upstream for each of these locations. So header, body, and footer has three upstreams, so different three different microservices that Nginx will call to render that content. So everything gets rendered in the frame service and gets sent back to the client. So that's the job of the frame microservice. And that's pretty much it. On the architecture repo, I have this small little ASCII document showing we have the frame UI and it's rendering using SSI remote calls to these three microservices. And this is how to bootstrap it. So you Docker compose up. So if we say Docker compose up, we start up everything. It should all be running. And you can see we have the website running. And each of these areas are served by three different microservices. Okay guys, so that's it for this video. Be sure to like and subscribe. And I want to keep these videos like short and condensed with information so we can cover a topic and move on to the next one. And stay tuned for the next one. We'll be covering continuous delivery with Docker and Kubernetes. So we'll be deploying this on every change. It'll automatically deploy. So we'll look at some tools for achieving that. Cool. So peace.